The poor emperor looked down. No one was pretending anymore, so he couldn't either. They were quite right. He had nothing on. At all. He blushed as red as a tomato and hid under the Prime Minister's long cloak, just like he used to do with his auntie when he was ashamed of something that he had done.
Minnie, Jenny,
the emperor said.
I want to go home. I think I've been very silly.
By the time the emperor got back to his palace, I know you won't be at all surprised to hear that the two supposedly magic tailors had disappeared. And funnily enough, so had all the gold, silver, pearls, emeralds, and rubies. Of course, this meant that the emperor had no money to buy any more new clothes. He thought for a long time about how silly he'd been, and then he made up his mind. He sent all his credit cards back, and he gave all the clothes in his wardrobe to Oxfam. He kept just two pairs of jeans and a few stripy t-shirts, and that was it. And because he wasn't spending half the day getting changed and the other half in clothes shops, he spent more of his time at work, governing his country, building schools and libraries, hospitals and swimming pools, which meant that the country became altogether a better place to live. So perhaps, in the end, it was all for the best. But then fairy tales always have a happy ending, don't they?
Highbrow, World Book Night 2012.